After winning the Lok Sabha elections in 2014, the Amit Shah-led Bharatiya Janata Party managed to paint the map almost entirely saffron through its numbers in the state assemblies. The political map of India was considered to be hit by a phenomenon then called the Modi wave. That could, however, only last till 2017 when the Modi Shah game of numbers through alliances started to backfire. To a point that in the 13 states that it apparently won since 2017, the BJP had a clear majority to form an independent government in only 6. What this implies is that in the states of Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Gujarat, Karnataka and Tripura, the BJP could survive on its own without the support of its allies, while in the rest of the states, its power is questionable. In Meghalaya, for example, the party could only secure 2 out of the 60 seats. While the Indian National Congress came up as the largest party with 21 seats, the BJP managed to form the government by joining alliances with 4 other parties other than its oldest ally, the NCP, which could only manage 1 seat. Though it doesn't have its chief minister in the state. In a similar case in Manipur, the INC emerged as the single largest party in the assembly elections with 28 seats. Yet the BJP, along with NPP, NPF and LPJ, formed the government and has a chief minister in the state. The so-called Chanakya Niti of the BJP president had managed to strike a pre-poll alliance with the Shiv Sena in Maharashtra for the 2019 assembly polls. While the BJP won 105 out of the 152 seats it contested, as the recent chain of dramatic events in the state show, the Modi Shah game did backfire.
Me, Uddhav Balasaheb Thakre, Ishwar Shapat Ghetto Ki, Kaidadware Stapit Zale Ahe.
As Ajoy Ashirwad Mahaprashasta from The Wire stated in his article, BJP under the leadership of Modi and Shah has been at the forefront of exploiting the volatility of Indian politics. It has been engineering deflections in its favour not only among the opposition ranks, as in Karnataka and Goa, but also its allies. In 8 of the state assemblies formed in the latest phase of elections, the Modi Shah party could not form a government at all.
The point is that while the BJP leadership, especially Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah, has often projected opposition alliances as opportunistic and unholy, the BJP itself has increased its national footprint by getting into such unlikely alliances. Let me give you a few examples. In Manipur and Goa, where the BJP finished second to the Congress, it stitched up post-poll alliances with regional parties, which it was always opposed to, and formed the state government there. Then again, BJP engineered mass defection in the Congress later to emerge as the biggest party in Goa. In Jammu and Kashmir, it partnered with an unlikely ally, Mehbooba Mufti's People's Democratic Party, to grab power. It broke up with PDP months before the 2019 general elections. Since then, the Modi government has treated PDP as nothing less than a separatist force. It has put Mehbooba Mufti in detention ever since it withdrew the state's constitutional autonomy. Similarly, through the infamous Operation Lotus, the BJP is seen to be the backseat driver of mass defections in the ruling Congress Janata Dal secular combined then in Karnataka. Riding on the support of rebel MLAs, it came to power in the state. We all know how in Bihar, the BJP did not hesitate to form government with Nitish Kumar as the chief minister. It was the BJP which ran a concerted campaign for months against Nitish Kumar and made multiple allegations of corruption against his government when he was in alliance with Lalu Prasad led Rashtriya Janata Dal. The BJP's lust for power has been such that in most of these occasions, the centre has used constitutional offices like the governor's or the Prime Minister's office or even the President's office for its own political gains. Modi and Shah may say that everything they do is for the best interests of the country, but the Machiavellianism of it all is for everyone to see.
While in Arunachal, the BJP had formed government twice earlier, but the MLAs were mostly those who had won elections on Congress tickets and were later shopped by the BJP. Only in the elections held early this year could the BJP form its first ever government with MLAs who contested the polls on the party's symbol. In the last assembly polls in both Manipur and Meghalaya, even though Congress was the single largest party, it was not called to form a government by the governors. Instead, the BJP was called in Manipur, which stitched up an alliance with NPP and NPF and kept the chief ministership to itself. In Meghalaya, since BJP won only two seats, it couldn't call it to lead the alliance government and instead called NDA partner NPP to form a multi-party government. Though the BJP's win in Assam in 2016 is talked about as a big one for the party, it didn't have a majority on its own. The party could win hands down only in Tripura. So the Tripura win in 2018 was the BJP's first major win in a northeastern state where it didn't need an alliance partner to form a government. In Nagaland too, it is a part of an alliance government and doesn't have a chief minister.
With these statistics and changing trend in the election numbers, the Chanakya Niti of the BJP president seems to be failing the Modi government at the state level.
To receive instant updates on all videos from The Wire, click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. Pay to support independent journalism. Click the link in the description and choose the amount you want to pay.